Yeah, so okay, we've got flirt, and I think this is confirmation of what happened here. Someone definitely has a very flirty energy here. Children behind that to me is childish behavior, very flirty, very inconsistent, let go of control issues, love yourself first. Someone definitely had an energy of putting themselves out there. Spirit is saying, free yourself, stay optimistic. So this to me, I did see Nine of Swords quite a few times during meditation, and this indicates that the level of mental struggle we're going through and the energy, this is why I'm so sweating. My God, you guys, it's so crazy. It's that moment where you find, this is past life relationship. This is someone you've been with for a long time. And it's that moment when that moment of truth where you're just overwhelmed with emotions and you're struggling with what to do. And this is why we did see that very soon card, because you know what? Sometimes we have to give ourselves grace when we find out things like this and allow ourselves to feel our emotions, for a while. So let's see what guidance we have for you, Sag, on this energy. Give me more for guidance. Wow. Yeah, Three of Swords, heartache and loss. This is very severe. It's a lot to process. Yeah, trapped in fear, Eight of Swords. A lot of mind energy, you guys. A lot of swords energy here. The mind is racing. And it's because we have to make, a decision here, and this troubling, I feel just a troubling energy of just disappointment, just also like disappointment. And there goes the Nine of Swords. I'm not surprised. Suffering in silence, Empress energy, again, long-term relationship, you could be the feminine energy here. But we have heart chakra, the heart, yes. This is a lot of, I just feel for you. Whoever's resonating with this, I feel for you because this is heavy. Okay? And your heart just needs grounding. So firm foundation, Four of Pentacles. This is really going to change everything, your foundation. And then we have power here. This is the Strength card, Leo energy. And this is, you've got to somehow pull it out of you and find this courage, right? Freeing yourself. This is actually, I know it doesn't feel that way, but this is actually a moment in time where you get to break free from a chapter of your life that I feel is divine intervention, especially with the way I'm feeling. This has caused you way too much stress already. And it's almost like a confirmation at this point. And again, maybe we turned away and didn't bother to see, want to see, but it feels like something is blatantly in someone's face here. So give him on his heartache and loss, please. Yeah, Five of Swords, and what I'm feeling is lack of understanding. This is a lose-lose situation here with this Five of Swords, where you're not going to get the explanations you want right now. You feel very caught off guard with the Two of Swords. Again, lots of swords energy, so the mind is racing here. Okay, more of this heartache and loss. I want to see one more. Let's see any more energies for this heartache and loss, spirit. Devil, you guys, I can't even make this up. It's happened, okay? This is definitely for someone in a third party situation. And this reading is definitely for someone who needs to reflect. So give me more of this trapped in fear, Eight of Swords. Not knowing what to do. Yep. Page of Swords. Some of you found out through investigation here. So some of you really, really found out through investigation, or someone came and told you something they saw. Eight of Swords, again, not wanting to see you guys. Someone did not want to know about this. And now it's blatantly, it feels like it's blatantly in your face because either someone you know has seen them. There's a confirmation that can't be unseen right now. So give me this heart chakra. So much swords energy, you guys. So much swords. You got Two of Wands and Queen of Swords. Yep. This is your contemplation stage. You need to take care of your heart right now. This is a revelation of the burdens you have carried. And there's an initiation, I feel, with this Queen of Swords. And the Queen of Swords is the single person, you know, the single suits of the deck, really, when divorces happen, separations happen, but also when, you know, a partner passes as well. But in this case, I really feel that there's an initiative here that you need to stand for yourself and your heart. You really need to spend some time processing your heart. Again, a decision this very soon, this Two of Wands. But this is a place of grace because the heart chakra deserves grace. Give me more of this Queen of Swords energy. I also am hearing no looking back. Yeah, there goes the courage, strength card, and the Fool. Exactly. Queen of Swords, no looking back. Right? It's the strength that's needed to restabilize your life and no longer look back. Some of you can be dealing with Gemini, Leo, air sign, but there goes the Tower. So this is definitely a divine intervention, a spirit force ending. So give me more on this firm foundation. Yeah, the past energy, Six of Cups, and there goes the Nine of Swords. You know, either way, the attachment, right? The energy I'm feeling. It's this Four of Pentacles feels like a moment of processing. And so there's still either you're still in the home. Obviously, some of you shared a home, so you're in the home. Too many memories or too many things that kind of remind you of this person. Or your mind is just racing of the many times that they disrupted your spirit and your spirit warned you and you may have ignored. So let me see what this Nine of Swords energy. Yeah, there you go. The World, Five of Swords. You knew there was someone. You knew they were hiding something with the High Priestess. Nine of Swords again. There was someone, and sometimes we deny and choose to look away, but there's an acceptance that needs to happen here. And this is definitely a spirit. I can't stress how much of a spirit force ending this is. This is also for your protection. This is for your protection. For whoever this resonates, this is for your protection. So here we're on the Strength. Give me more of the strength. Give me more of the strength. Yep. Three of Swords, the heartache, guys. We've got Three of Cups, the Lovers, the Sun. This is definitely an illumination of what's happened here. Three of Swords. And there goes the Empress. So someone you've been long-term with. You guys could be dealing with a Libra, but this is an emotional injury. This illumination of what happened is an emotional injury. And to me, this is a stage of processing, right? Some of us, Four of Pentacles, again, not willing to let go, but recognize that that's a stage. Eventually, this will have to be let go because we can't hold on to someone who doesn't want us, right? You know, that's just a lesson, and it just is. And eventually the other side of this, right? That's what Spirit is saying, free yourself, stay optimistic. The other side of this, you got to find the sun within you somehow, especially if you guys have children, right? Children are here. So if you have kids, you're going to have to co-parent. You're going to have, there's a lot that has to take place here. And do know that sometimes our responses are very emotional, even though if for those of you, if this person obviously wasn't a good person, cheater, in this case, definitely a cheater, then just do yourself a favor and let it just go. You know, I know it's easier said than done, but let me tell you something. Sag, you know, I have my my partner also going through a divorce now, and it's kind of crazy because it's very emotional. I mean, the lawyer is gonna make some money out of this because there's no assets. There's just you know visitations that needs to be. They have no assets, zero assets together, nothing, no house, no nothing. It's an easy clean. Let's move on. She obviously cheated, so it's actually similar, you know, similar energy, because this has been going on for some time. So a lot of people are closing chapters, and that's really the key here, is that we're closing chapters, and it's a good thing. But sometimes people hold on, and this, you know, my partner's ex is unwilling to deal with the moving on. You know, she left him for someone else. At this point, it's been 2 years, but she doesn't want to sign. And you know, it's because she wanted back in, but you know, that option is not there, and it's hard to let the idea go. So now the next stage to harm would be through children, right? Through the children. And now there's a lot of issues with putting rules of when he can see his child and when not, and that's when, to me, things get complicated, because those are people who operate from wounds and think that they're doing justice for themselves, but the truth is they're harming. That equates to child abusing. And you know, if someone wants to participate still in their child's life, that should still be allowed. We're all gonna move on. You know, I know I'm going off tangent here, but I think there's a reason for this. We're all gonna move on, you know. People come and go, and that's part of the soul's evolution. And clearly there was no happiness here. So why? This has to be a newfound happiness. And sometimes there are lessons behind this that we have to learn ourselves. And in her case, you know, she was very narcissistic, but those people never learn. But, you know, she's very bully. I've seen the messaging. It's almost creepy, you guys, honestly. But people, we're not here to change. So if some of you were dealing with a narcissist, that's not your job to change. It's not, you know, that's their life lesson. And Spirit is trying to take you to your take you to, and elevate you elsewhere, to move you away from this dark energy. This is demonic, you guys. Like, we don't want to be here. And it's probably why it makes you, maybe some of you are dealing with the foggy brain, the cloudedness. And this could be a clearing of that. That's why swords are very strong here. So the heart chakra needs to heal for you to see. And Spirit is saying, get the courage to set yourself free. So very important message here, Sag. This is definitely for someone. So let's see what the blockages are, Spirit. What are the blockages here? Right, so release old emotional wounds are keeping you in a karmic cycle, crying, let go. This is exactly what it is. It's an emotional wound that we somehow find, Sag, this can become a person's identity. You know, our wounds can become our identity. And when we realize what's really difficult to let go is the story. And that's how it keeps you in a karmic cycle. So it's almost like the emotional injury. There's comfort in the emotional injury. And that's exactly what we have next. Comfort. Step out of your comfort zone. Someone needs to like clear way and see things for what it is and realize this is not, this is a cycle that's done. And free will, you get to make all of your decisions come from love. Yes, understanding our free will, also understanding our self-love. And I think this is where the courage needs to be. Strength is here twice, and this pain needs to be there. When we cling on to something that is so harmful to us, then there isn't self-love yet. And so that needs to be found as well. And memories, time to face the triggers. Yeah, that's exactly what I feel here, you guys, where I was feeling like there's just a lot of you guys have things maybe still in the same home or memories in the home or something. There's a replay of memories. And now it's time to face the trigger. And yeah, that energy also where time to face the triggers, meaning maybe for a long time, maybe a few of you were just looking away and actually knew the truth all this time and just looked away, but it didn't mean you weren't suffering, you know. And now it's time to face the triggers, right? It's time to face the triggers of all the past hurt, all the stuff you did see, you ignored. It's part of the processing, but I promise you it's part of the healing. So let's get you a guidance here, Spirit. Let's get a guidance for our Sag. Yeah, forgiveness. The time has come to forgive others and to finally forgive yourself. We are all human, and we all make mistakes. Being able to forgive will lead you to unconditional love, compassion, and ultimate happiness. Yeah, and bottom of the deck is let go. Time to walk away and let go of the situation or person. There is nothing in this moment that you can do to control it. Let go and release it. The universe knows what to do. Exactly. So at this point, there's an attachment to the pain, right? There's an attachment to the shoulda, coulda, would-haves. And in order for us to, our soul to heal and to proceed, we need to forgive and let go. You know, there's so much freedom in that. And I feel this is why Spirit is saying, stay optimistic, free yourself. So let's get one more guidance, Sag. Very heavy, I know. But that's what readers are here for, us readers who illuminate, you know, and show the light at the end of the tunnel. I mean, easier said than done, but it's a must. So let's see what else we've got. Too many here. Look at this bottom. Illumination. Wow. That's exactly what the sun is. It's so much that was illuminated here. So much that did not want to be seen. And so light from flames will begin to illuminate everything around you, revealing how things truly are. Yeah. This is a process. And I'm seeing NOV here, which is interesting. I don't even know if I'm supposed to be NOV. Oh, no vacancy, but NOV is what I see. So from here to November, I do feel there will be some light, you know, like you'll feel some light energy after there's an acceptance, because it seems like there's an acceptance necessary along the way. I really feel this energy of not fighting it and just closing this chapter. And that's that. So, Sag, I love you. I'm gonna close this already.